It is good to see you guys out, man. I was talking to the producers. They're like, hey, Emo, we're very excited to have you on the show. We just have a question. Have you booked your accommodation yet? I said, no, I haven't. I'm just looking for somewhere close by, cultured. As soon as I said cultured, they said, we got the perfect place. We said Blacktown.
Is that actually a town here?
It is a town.
I was like, ooh, that sounds nice. As soon as I got there, I was like, ooh, this ain't nice. So I moved areas. I thought this area was nice. It was called Penrith. Have you heard of this?
Yeah,
it's rough. But it is a massive upgrade from Blacktown, though, because I went from living around poor black people to now living around poor white people. And I love it. Every now and then, I've been getting like a random white guy come up and ask me for like loose change. And I give it to them. But I do it for the wrong reasons though, ladies and gentlemen. I do it because I kind of feel like I'm rewriting history. Every time I give him change, I'm like, here you go, my man. Just don't spend it all on drugs. If only my mum could see me now. Oh, she's not dead, she's just not here. I was speaking to her on FaceTime this morning. She's like, hey, how's Penrith gone? I'm like, ma, it's so beautiful, very multicultural. You should see it. The white people ask me for money. And she was so proud. She's like, oh my God, you're doing very well, my son. And then she calls my father into the FaceTime. She's like, Michael, come have a look at your son. He has become the king of the whites. I'm gonna get buzzed off soon. can I get some water? Sorry, just one moment. Oh, my mouth is so dry.
Here we go.
Ooh. Oh, how unprofessional, I'm so sorry. Water is very hard for black people to find. There's been a lot of tension between white and black people over the last couple of years. But I think it's because we don't understand each other because of our differences in culture. And for us to ever move forward, I feel like we all have to do our part. Would you agree?
Yes.
Yes, I think white people, you need to stop assuming that all black people are out to steal things that are not theirs. And black people, man, we need to stop trying to steal back our stuff from white people, man. I think it's important if we're ever going to make a change, we have to start educating the younger generation. Like, for example, white people, you need to stop lying to your kids. This is my personal favorite lie. Make sure you finish off all your dinner because somewhere in Africa, there's a child that would love to eat it. Nonsense. What you guys don't realize is African parents tell their kids a similar thing. Like, I remember my mom used to tell me, son, make sure you finish off all your dinner because somewhere in Australia, there's a child eating food without seasoning, son. This is sick. Australia Got Talent. Who would have thought that the kid that survived two refugee camps would be on TV? Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Emo Majuk. Thank you.
Yeah!
Oh, very, very good.
That was fantastic.
Thank you, man.
Fantastic.
Yeah. This is yours.